Hi, I'm here with Chewy, the Lhasa, and Chewy has a horrifically thick coat. He wasn't matted. He might have had a few tangles, but there was no way you would get a good brush or comb through his coat. So before I started trimming, I washed and blow dried him. When I blow dry, I use a pin brush on a super thick coat until the coat is about 90% dry. My goal is not to brush the dog completely out. My goal is to get the dog dry and the hair separated somewhat. Usually it works quite good, penetrating all the way to the skin, but I do most of the brushing first this way. And then I go to a stiffer slicker, and holding the skin taut, I give it a good brushing. I don't have to worry on a coat this thick about putting some pressure into it. I do not use high velocity dryers in my salon, so I blow dry these guys by hand. And even as thick as his coat is, it went pretty quick. So once I brush the entire dog over with the heavier slicker, putting a little pressure in, you can see that's getting out some dead undercoat. Chewy's going to get our most common hairstyle, which is short, but not too short. I think I will do a four on the trunk of the body, scissor the legs, and round the head. Chewy's a rescue dog. He's got a very funny personality. He is extremely protective of his owner at home, like most Lhasas are. But there's a husband and wife, and he protects one person from the other, don't you? So after I get all that done, then on a super thick coat, I'm only going to use a wide tooth comb. Check over him, going all the way to the skin, comb the hair. Good boy, he's so cute. He's got a mat in his tail, so I'm just going to use thinning shears. You can see he immediately gets fussy if he thinks you're going to tug on him. Good boy. All right, so now let's get busy. I'm gonna do the pads of his feet. Now his front set, when dogs come in with any mats anywhere in their hair, because it's not a comfortable process, is it? No, it's not. It's okay. Come here. Good boy. All right, so now we're going to do around his eyes. To do it around his eyes, I'm going to stretch the skin back. And just with the edge of the blade, just lightly scoop it. I'm using a 10 blade for this. I used a 40 blade on the feet. Good boy. I'm going to see if I can get some of this hair off the front of his lips. Good boy. Oh, that was so good. That was so good. Now with the 10 blade, I'm going to do his tummy. Lightly trim under his tail with a 7. In my salon, I use a 7 under the tail or a 5 to prevent any possibility of the one in every 50, 60, 70 dogs who might not feel comfortable with it trimmed so close. Every now and then you get one that doesn't like it. It's okay, bud. No. And sometimes when you go to lift up their tail, they have memories of the veterinarian sticking a thermometer up there. So we'll be careful of that. Okay. Good boy. I'm not gonna hurt you. I promise. He's a rescue dog. There's no telling what his past experiences were.
Right. Do people do mean things back there?
And he's got a little hard, lumpy place back here. It's probably from his vaccine.
All right. So, now. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready? He's like, I don't like you now. Let's see. Do you like me? Oh, you do like me. I thought you did.
Excuse the baby talk. All right, so here we go with the foreblade. Now he's marked like a tiger under here. He's very brindle. He had a little mat back there I was getting out. This way. Always check your blade, make sure it's not getting too hot. I always try to follow the direction in which the hair grows if I'm trimming with the grain. What I mean by with the grain is when it goes in that direction. When I'm following the direction, the pattern of the hair growth. If I went straight down, I would get lines. If I went straight across, I would get lines. Turn you this way.
That's a good boy.
This way. So most customers, when they bring their dogs in, their request is, I want them short, but not too short. So, as you can see, the length of this hair is very short up here. And I'm getting a lot of hair off. But most customers do not like to see skinny legs. It's okay. I'm gonna have to work without lifting up his tail. He doesn't like that. Just put it to the side. Let's get some of this hair in here.
Good boy. Good boy. Yeah.
On thick coats, I stand the hair up to cut it. On thin and silky coats, I lay it down. I think for him, I'm going to give him a cute little teddy bear face today. I didn't have any really specific instructions. And this owner, for the last 15, 16 years with their dogs, has always had them shaved bald. They decided to make him cute today. He didn't give me any real specifics, so I got my own free will. Happens when you don't give your groomer instructions.
Yes, it is. We can have fun. Just to have fun with the pupper.
So I usually go against the grain underneath because I want it one step shorter than the back. We go against the grain up under here. And then, since I'm going to try to give him a cute little teddy bear face, I'm going to take the chin off of the fore blade. The blade is still cool because I'm using the clipper on low. Just behind the eyes short, not all the way up under. In front of the ear and behind the eye. Against the grain with the form. It'll just save me some time. Alright. Go back over that pattern in a little while. Get the feet scissored. All right, so we're going to minimize this easty-westy front. The front feet that go in two separate directions. So I'm gonna keep the feet on the floor to trim them. And start with the outside. Get it as close to the foot as I can. Toenail there. Now I'm going to fake the front of the foot. So he's already got this dip here before I start scissoring. So I'm going to take it close at the top. Leave it full at the bottom. I had a groomer who's been grooming for 50 years the other day watch one of my groomings and say, "I never saw you pick up that dog's foot." And this is one of the reasons. I know she keeps giving me the sweetest kisses. Is when you are doing cosmetic grooming like this, if you pick up the foot, you ruin it. And I'm just faking on the inside, keeping it a lot more hair on the inside of the foot to change the direction. So now I'm going to do the same thing with this foot. He's already missing this hair. So I'm going to have to try to minimize that by going super close up at the elbow. Probably shouldn't have let him sit when I was trimming it either, because that changed the direction the elbow was going. So even though I left the hair longer down here at the foot, I took it super close right at the knuckle. And then two on the back of the foot. Let me see. You have to leave a lot of hair in here so that this comes straight to the floor. Because if I took this off, his foot would look completely out of balance.
Stand. Good boy. Aw, thank you for those kisses. Thank you. Here. And stand. And here. Stand. Good boy. Great.
So what I'm trying to do is make the legs look as much like pillars as I can. Even though his bones are completely like this. And all the while I'm not leaving too much hair anywhere. Don't want too short or too long. So I'm going to leave those and come back to them again in a few minutes. I tend to work around the dog quite a bit so they don't get frustrated. Back feet don't need the cosmetic work. And then as I go, I'm just going to keep lifting up the tail, even though I'm not working under there, just to desensitize him to me doing that, so that when I do need to do it, he's not going to be so touchy. If I keep doing it and nothing happens, then he's not going to be so stressed about it. Good boy. Good boy. So I'm noticing whenever he has something he really doesn't want me to do is when he kisses me. He's trying to be very sweet and talk me out of it. Aren't you? Come on. Papa. Trying to tug me out of this one too. Stand. Stand. Here you go, one.
His Lhasa is showing.
They're stubborn. I want you right there. So to keep him from turning, I have my arm underneath and my hand up. And that's keeping him where I want him. I'm not propping him up. If I were, I would take my hand away because then it would become a game. Sometimes the more you prop a dog up, the more they lean on you. And I don't play that game. I just keep pulling everything up and seeing if there's anything needs something. The main purpose of my videos are not to be educational. They are to show clients the different hairstyles that I have available, how they're done, how I work with the dogs. But I do tell people what I'm doing and how in case they do want to glean something from it. And that's great. Good boy. Good boy. That's very good. Take this hair on top of his nose and fan it up. Good boy. Good. I was praising him because he was pushing his head into my hand. And I'm going to softly round off the top of this. If he'll let me do it with thinning shears, I might have to do it quickly with scissors. Let's see. Alright, don't you get nasty with me. Yeah, he doesn't like the thinning shears. We're gonna have to do it with scissors. It's okay. It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt you. It's okay. Just fine, my man. Not gonna hurt the puppy. Good. Be nice. No, you be nice. Put those teeth back in your mouth. Nobody wants to see them things.
Nobody wants to see them crooked teeth. No.
So mostly Lhasas are very funny little dogs. If you cross them, they will definitely let you know it. Very territorial. Great guard dogs. And they really appreciate kindness. And if you're not nice to them, they'll never trust you again. They remember who their friends are. Praised him because he rested his head on my hand instead of pulling it away, and that was good. That was very good. Very good boy. See now he's laying it on my hand. That's perfect. It means he's giving it to me. Instead of me having to take it. See that? He laid his head and pressed it into my hand. Very good. So many times I've seen groomers over the years get irritated, and a dog is pulling and thrashing his head around like that, and they'll start saying, "No, no, stop," and they kind of pull their head down. That does nothing but create a battle. That's purely my opinion. But my ways work for me. Good, he did it again. Good. Very good boy. Yes. Very good boy. That's perfect. It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt him. I'm not gonna hurt him. Come on. Good. You don't like that direction, do you? Good boy. That was it. That was it. Yeah. do with these ears.
Thank you, bud.
So if you look at the hairstyle options page on my website, this would be a puppy trim number 4 with short beard and short ears. When you look at the website and you see it pictured from the front, it looks a little longer than it actually is. The 4 blade on the back is what makes it look short. And the scissored legs is what makes it look full. So it's a balance. Seconds ago. I know what happened. You started panting. And it just pushed all that right out. Come on, start panting again. There you go. With their mouth closed, sometimes it looks so good, and then they start panting and it goes.
Go this way.
It's starting to look like a puppy. So now I'm gonna brush the entire dog because he has such thick hair. Clean off my table so I can see what's left. And after I rebrush, I'm gonna recomb. Now while this brushing sounds hard, he's got a super thick coat, so it actually takes a little pressure to get through it. So now, I'm gonna mist him with coat conditioner. And I'm going to re-clipper the back. Doesn't he have cute colors? Table clean again. Boom. And recomb. I praised him for letting me snip under the tail. You're getting tired. I'm sorry. We're almost done.
good point. He's a good boy. There. You don't like facing in this direction, do you? Let me see. Let me see. A little knot up under his arm.
I remember correctly, they found him at the Humane Society of Tampa Bay. Cute little rescue dog. Had a few little behavioral problems, but he's being trained through them, learning his manners. Aren't you? You're learning. There's our short, but not too short, Lhasa trim with a short face, short ears, medium short tail, and corrective grooming on the front legs to make them look much straighter. Look this way, bud. Good boy. This way. Trying to get him to look straight on, where you can see his eyes. Because he's got that black face. Yeah, that's a good boy.